drinks to strangers just to pay my bills, yeah. I spend my nights in the darkness. He only lights them pills. I feel the heat of the fire, but I don't see no flame, no. It's just a burning desire that's running through these veins, yeah. And I feel it now, I tell you. So heavy. So heavy. So heavy. So heavy.
Gave you all my love. I even sold my soul.
Together as a group, and we try to kind of all move forward as a group. So I don't really think of myself as a leader as much as we're all kind of walking the same path together. Yeah, exactly.
Awesome.
So we got four gentlemen, all very talented, very cool people. To my left, I have Mr. Gold Griffith. To my right, I have the Bishop, and our hidden fourth is Cloud Dukes, who is currently on vacation, getting his bass finger stretched out a little more for the next show, you know?
If you want to call it a bass finger.
If you want to call it a bass finger, you know?
I started with the music when I was like 9. I actually started in church, so that kind of gauged my style. Church, and kind of moved around from there. You know, as soon as my foot can reach the foot pedal. So that's what kind of got me into it, at church watching different drummers.
I'm like Steve Martin.
Yeah. I mean, hey,
else do it, so.
You're taller than me, so I had a hard time. Only imagine that.
And you're left-handed, too.
Yeah, left-handed, yeah. Yeah?
I'm there with you.
Okay, yes, yeah.
So I got started in music when I was very young. My father was actually a Grammy-nominated producer. So it was always kind of in my family. And I got started in choir. I went through arts middle school, arts high school. I went through both my undergrad and my graduate degree in opera. So I was at Georgia State and then at Florida State. And I picked up a guitar probably around 13 or 14. So I kind of have done, I've done barbershop music, I've done choir, I've done musical theater, I've done opera around the world, I've done rock and roll. So I'm, you know, I'm a career musician. It's all I've ever done.
I am also a son of a musician. My pop's a blues man. So yeah, I've been in the club since I was a little boy. And yeah, I've been doing music, making my own music, writing, producing, playing guitar for pretty much my whole life. So yeah, I do it because I love it. I couldn't do nothing more, even if it wasn't paying, you know?
Totally agree with you.
Kind of similar to now. It ain't paying.
Hey, it pays somehow. You know?
Edgewood Heavy. That was Heavy, an original song written by us. And yeah, we're gonna keep this going right here. I go by the name of Gold, and this is Save My Soul. Thank you.
little ghetto boy, playing in the ghetto street. What you gonna do when you grow up and have to face responsibility? Little ghetto boy, playing in the ghetto street. What you gonna do when you grow up and have to face responsibility?
So our original music as a group is really an echo of the sound that we have as a group, where we're all kind of coming from different places and different musical backgrounds. So when you hear our original music, you're kind of starting to hear maybe a little bit of the funk and blues that Gold brings to the table. Mm-hmm. And you're going to bring hear a little bit of the like soul and training that I'm bringing to the table. You're going to hear some of the lifetime of drumming and some of the church influence that Bishop is bringing to the table. You're going to hear a little bit more of the like straight rock bass lines that Cloud brings to the table. So that's really the cool thing about our sound, is that just like in the selection of songs we play in our set list, you hear all of these really unique pieces coming together to make one even more unique whole.
Genre? I mean, are we being specific?
No, a song. Let's just take a particular song and just move you in a line.
Let's go with, I can go with John Mayer, Slow Dancing.
Awesome.
Yeah, I like that one a lot.
Why does it hit with you? What communicates with
you? It's very relaxing.
Yeah. It's got quite a mood to it.
Quite a mood to it. Then I like when Gio do it. I think Gio actually do it better than John Mayer.
Woof, thank you, Bishop. That's quite a compliment.
That is.
Yeah, I mean, I hate to echo, but mine is actually a John Mayer tune also. My favorite song is actually my favorite song to play, and that is Stop This Train by John Mayer, which is a really moving song physically, because you play it on an acoustic guitar and you do this tapping motion the whole time that gives it a percussiveness as if you had a drummer. And then that, along with the fingerstyle picking, it actually sounds like a locomotive moving the whole time. And it's just one of my favorites because it's very dynamic. I can make it loud. I can make it soft. I can make people want to cry. I can make people think about their parents. It's just a really beautiful, singular piece of holistic art, I think.
I change songs weekly. So this week, this week, what I've been listening to most is Sunshine by Roy Ayers. And I don't know why, but that, man, what I feel when I feel what I feel what I'm feeling, that should do something to me right here for some odd reason this week.
Especially with the sun coming out.
This week, is that what it is?
That must be what it is.
Man.
I go by the name of Gio Yaquinto.
Giovanni Yaquinto.
One, two, three, four. Well, so in love with you. Yeah. Whatever you. Yeah, loving you forever.
says I need us to do, baby. Baby, let's, we got to stay together. Loving you well, times are good or bad, happy or sad, yeah. Ooh, 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 ooh. Well, the times are good or bad, happy or sad, yeah. Why? Tell me, baby, why do people break up? Yeah, they turn around and make up. I just can't see. 'Cause you'd never do that to me, would you, baby? Is all I see, yeah. Baby, let's, we got to stay together, yeah. Loving you weather. Times are good or bad, happy or sad.
Let's stay together.
And that's something, you know, I'd love to compliment Gold a little bit on. You know, one of the things that he brings to the band is his understanding of how to not only control dynamics, but the trajectory of a song and to move an audience with his ability to do that. And he'll be, you know, real adamant in our rehearsals. He's like, no, I want to break this down here. No, I want to make sure that this is really tight here. He understands showmanship. And that's a big part of why Edgewood Heavy shows are so much fun.
Well, Gold, you got it going on, man.
Can't you see, man? What?
I take that all back, actually. Yeah,
take it all back.
Besides just dynamics, I think that's one thing that our group really has going for us. And this is something that Bishop actually saw when the band was first getting together, more than Gold and I saw it, is that the difference of styles that we bring to the table really makes it to where we can captivate any audience. You know, depending on who's in the room, depending on who's excited, we'll know which songs in our repertoire to call from. And we'll know which ones are going to hit with certain demographics. And we know how to make sure people have a good time.
I was just basically going back with him, what he was saying. Yeah. Knowing the room, being able to bounce the ball, pass the ball. Because it might be times where he might see a certain crowd come in and he might pass it to Gio. Mm-hmm. And Gio might take it and run with it. And Gio see another group of people come in. He pass it back to Gold. And I think that right there.
We go by the name of Edgewood Heavy. We're touring all around Atlanta. Make sure to follow us on Instagram and keep up with the heavy. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. was in L.A.
If I was in L.A.
California dreaming. I'm such a winter's day. We'll be right back.
Break up. Now every day I wake up, somebody got a problem with gold. What's up, suckers all fed up, cause I got a little cheddar and my record's moving out the store. First the fat boys break up, now every day I wake up, somebody got a problem with gold. What's up, suckers all fed up, cause I got a little cheddar and my record's moving out the stores. Where's the love? Gio, where the love, Gio?
It ain't in the love of the, ain't in the heart of the city, I'll tell you that much. And I don't trust myself with loving it anyway, so. I don't know about all that now, hey.
My pop's favorite tune, which is my first choice, you know, which I always say in interviews, is my probably one of my favorite records also. Well, it's definitely one of my favorites, top three, is Ooh Child by the Four stair step, the five stair steps. Is it five or four?
I don't know how many stair steps there are, man.
The four stair steps. I believe that's correct. But great band. Yeah, amazing song. I first heard it, and it was on the soundtrack from Boys in the Hood. Ah, oh, man, amazing scene. He was driving. He was getting locked up. Dope boy was getting arrested, and he was pulling up, and they saw him. And then his dad said some real profound words. I don't remember exactly what he said, but it stuck with me, man. That record, that Ooh Child, right there, every time.
Amazing how things stick. And I mean, that was pretty young for you.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, absolutely. But, you know.
You down in single digits when you heard that?
Yeah, absolutely. All of my, everything that sticks with me was from back then, man. Everything. Because, you know, that's when you was coming up. I remember being a fucking, before I can remember anything, listening to Muddy Waters in the living room, my pops was listening to it in his bedroom, you know, remembering Hoochie Coochie Man and remembering, you know, When the Lights Go Out, you know, those records. But, you know, and that's why I know them now. I know them unconsciously. Yeah. And that's it. Thanks, Pop. Me and Gio Wright, Bishop and Cloud, they're more musicians. Well, Cloud writes too, somewhat. But yeah, we writers. We the writers.
I think that as a group, we're still kind of finding our dynamic of how we write and the exact process of how we get our songs done. Because, you know, the ones that we've had so far, a lot of them, gold is kind of brought to the table and brought to me, and we would embellish upon and work on. And then we'd bring it to the band and say, all right, guys, let's get a whole project coming from this single thread. And then we sew a tapestry, you know?
Sew a tapestry.
I like that.
Take a single thread, sew a tapestry.
Carol King kind of thought that.
You write that? Yeah. Okay. Sew a tapestry.
We allow each other to be yourself. So what you good at, you do that.
Yep.
You good at the soul, you do the soul. Gio, you good at the taking your shirt off, running around the building, do that. We'll allow you to be yourself.
I kept it more modest for the HiFi Buys show. If they want to come see the live shows, they'll get a different Gio. You know.
Oh man, what on top of tables?
Now you're seeing the full dynamic. Getting right. Comfortable, but
don't bring your girlfriend. Don't bring your girlfriend. Hide your wife.
Hide your kids.
Hide your kids, because Gio is on the prowl, baby.
I don't know about all that. I don't know about all the prowl.
Hey, hey, hey. Don't be modest now.
Don't
be modest.
No girlfriend. Okay. No girlfriend.
I figured I
had to
put that out there.
Yeah.
You guys?
Oh, man. Oh, yeah, I'm definitely.
He's only.
He's booed up over there.
He's the only one that's got the ball and chain. We're single and ready to mingle. Me and the two G's over here. Yeah,
that's right. So if you pick a G, any G, you know? This one's a good 2020-2021 song. This one I'll talk to a lot of people who have had to quarantine and try to protect their loved ones. And we've all had to learn to be alone. So this is an original song of mine called Learning to Be Alone. Just you.
Take us some time.
gonna take us some time. But know that that's our high, that's our high.
Whenever you good at what you do, it's always gonna be one person that kind of like, you notice it went to him. Gio didn't say nothing because he know it's like, okay. But Goldie, he gonna, you know, that's a little
Goldie.
Bit.
Goldie. It's always Goldie, right? Isn't it?
Alan,
isn't it?
It's a little bit more.
You're the scapegoat, right?
You know,
hey, I'll be the goat. I'll be a goat.
It's more of a time frame thing. You know, me and Gold go back years to 09. So.
Really?
Yeah, so it's more personal.
Yeah, I've kicked him out of a couple of my bands.
That's more of a...
He keeps on coming back. Keeps on crawling back for more, huh?
Ever since 09, baby.
So did y'all play together
Like
I just said, I've kicked him out of multiple
Alan,
bands.
Don't even go for the hype.
I'll shut his mic off so you can speak.
Kill his mic. Unplug the mic. We started. We didn't know what we was doing. I mean, we had experience playing. I had more than him, but it was just us two at first, you know. And it was like, I'll be back. I'll come back after we, you know, get some things up under our belt. And as time went on, we always kept a good rapport, you know, friends and talked throughout the years. And now we back to do this. So everything worked out in time.
Awesome.
Never got kicked out though. The camera, where's the camera? Can I look at the camera?
You
no.
Can.
Never got kicked out. Don't believe the hype. Do not believe that. There we go.
Oh, and it's been a really interesting thing for me to come into this dynamic because, you know, I spent 10 years in the academic world singing opera and learning these languages and traveling around the world doing that, and I thought I was hot shit. And then I came into the singer-songwriter world and tried to put on a show, and I could play some songs, but I was still learning how to walk in that new pace. Right, so having these guys with me has been really, I think, transformative for my live show in this new genre, in that they've been doing this, you know, for years and years and years. So as a group, they've kind of helped me grow in a place where I wasn't as strong, and I hope that some of my strengths can help their weaknesses too. I think that our sound as a band is something that you haven't seen before, something that you haven't heard before, and... it was something that, like I said, I think the first person to realize it was actually Bishop. You know, he was saying that it's been commented that me and Gold singing together is like thunder at dawn, right? It's this weird combination of two very different things, and you put them together and somehow it works. And I think that's where we're headed. I think we're going to kind of redefine the sound of a band in the regard that we're not one lane, right? We can cover the whole highway.
All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're gonna keep this going.
Little girl, man.
never makes a man, but it's a man world. Hey, but it wouldn't be nothing, nothing without a woman or a little girl.
Shout out to Godfather of Soul, the greatest, James Brown. I can't be nobody else but me 100% of the day. So yeah, I'm me when I wake up. I dress like this when I go to the grocery store. And when I'm on stage, it's just, you know, it's the same. So, you know, I preach that to these guys, which they do already. But I'm like, hey man, be you. Be you times 10 when we up there, when we in front of people, you know what I mean? Just be you. The music that we make is going to be an extension of us. And it can't be an extension of us unless we are us. So let's be you. And, you know, people going to love it. You know, come smoke some weed with me. Come drink a drink with me. You know what I mean? You'll see. Ain't nothing going to change. Same shit. That's it. G?
I don't know. I kind of feel like I'm learning to completely express myself in everything I do because, you know, once again, I came from this very vastly different world. And even now, besides Edgewood Heavy, the other things that I'm doing are like kind of different colors of my personality, right? Or different colors of my sound as a musician, different colors of my skill sets. So while I feel like I express myself fully when I'm with Edgewood Heavy, I also feel like there's parts of me that are expressed when I do other things that aren't quite fully sounding when I'm with Edgewood Heavy, if that makes sense. Mm-hmm. So to say which part of me is truer, which part of me is the full me, is kind of impossible.
Well, you might be finding it.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. I definitely think that I'm still finding that sound that is the most authentic to me.
I will tell you, I'm almost 60 years old and I'm still finding me. So,
yeah.
I heard that, man.
Well, that master plan for us, kind of coming back to your question about what we see, good old Gold and I have been talking about music festivals since we got started. You know, we've said Bonnaroo, we've said, you know, Shaky Knees, we've seen, you know, we plan to see ourselves in all these really well-established things and giving these shows on these bigger stages. And you know, being that my father was a Grammy-nominated producer, it's my personal aspiration to win a Grammy, kind of bring it back for my family name. And Bishop has an expression that he likes to use about how we're moving. You want to share that with him, Bishop?
How we moving? To the top or too easy?
Both of them.
I mean, both. Whatever you just
see, we'll see you at the top. We'll see you at the top.
He caught me off guard. I'm like, okay, G, I don't know where you at right now, but I'm trying to figure out.
Hey fellas, are you hang out down in Jack's pool hall? Go down there and don't do nothing at all. Wanted to play some cards, it was a game in the back. You wanted a shot or something, went and talked to Jack. He had a little money, was a grade A fool. There was a guy down there who used to shoot a little pool. Rack him up, said rack him up. Didn't have no car. Hey, whatever Jack will make him back behind the bar. Used to have a wife, but she left him in tears. He hasn't been home once in 25 years. Rack him up. Rack him up. TV set, didn't have no car. Hey, whatever Jack can make him back behind the bar. He used to have a wife, but she left him in tears. He hasn't been home once in 25 years. Rack him up.
favorite band is a hard question, because the people that inspire me most as musicians are all those people that are solo names. You got people like Alan Stone and John Mayer and Hozier and all these people that are singer-songwriters, and they bring these people in around them. And I always thought that was going to kind of be the path for me, you know, Gio Yaquinto and whoever else I have around. But that's the beautiful thing about Edgewood Heavy, is that instead of it being my show and I have people with me, the people who I have with me are what define my show.
My favorite band is Parliament Funkadelics. And they do still tour. They've been touring for a long time. But yeah, man, it's a stage full of individuals. And that's it. We talked about it earlier. And you know, it was about that too. It wasn't just them up there. It was about being an individual. And everybody had a role. The roles went from top to the bottom. You know, you got George, who was the main role, and you got the guy with the elephant tusk on his nose, which had a small role, but everybody had a role, and that made the show. So I admire the fact that they could go out there and be 100% truly themselves, even if he was wearing a diaper, you know what I mean? So everybody's in, no one man over the crew, man. Bad boys for life. That's it, that's how we roll. So, yeah.
Well,
that's awesome.
With that said, we gonna keep this thing on. I got my man Bishop Balls on drums. Yeah, yeah. I'd rather be with you until I'm through. Oh yes, girl. I'd rather be with you until that day will fly away. I love the way you lie in the earth's eye. If I can't have you to myself, then life's no fun. I'd rather be with you. Stay warm.
silly little moment. It's not a stone before the calm. This is a deep and dark breath of this love that we've been working on. Can't seem to hold you like I want you, so I can feel you in my arms. Nobody's gonna come and save you. For too many false alarms going down, and you can see it too going down, and you know that we're doomed, my dear. Slow dancing in the say is nothing to me. Honey, you're the only light I ever saw. I make the most of all the sadness. You be a bitch because you can, yeah. You try to hit me, just let me, and you leave me feeling dirty because you can't understand. We're going down, and you can't see it.
A beat, we don't miss no beat. It's like listening to, you know, James Brown live, then listen to the album. Oh man, it's the same shit. You know, it's you can hear this live, but it's the same energy, same feel, you know. So yeah, we ain't missing no beats.
Edgewood Heavy is an Atlanta-based band, and we like to pay homage to some of our other Atlanta heroes. So this one goes out to our friends over at Outkast. Yeah. Got you cussed out of coming up short. Dig this now,
even though
need a golden calculator to divide. Time it takes to look inside and realize that real guys go for real down to Mars, girls. Ha! I know you like to think you don't. Roses really smell like boo boo boo.
Yeah,
roses really smell like boo boo boo.
Caroline, she's a reason for the word bitch.
Bitch.
hope she's speeding on the way to a club, trying to get herself a ball or a single or play or something like that. And she's putting the makeup on in the mirror, and then she crashed, she crashed, she crashed into a dip.
Just playing.
She needs a golden calculator to divide,
to divide
the time it takes to look inside and realize that real guys go for real.
Now, to Mars girls, ha, ha, I know you like to think your shit don't stink, but lean a little bit closer, see roses really smell like boo, boo, boo.
Yeah.
Roses really smell like boo, boo, boo.
Yeah.
Are y'all with
yeah.
me?
You better come back from Mars. Girl, quit chasing cars. What happens when you don't get slow, bitch? You ain't that fine. No way. No way. No way.
By the name of Edgewood Heavy, and we about to get it real heavy up in here, baby. Shout out to my favorite, the greatest. Rest in peace, Bill Withers. We love you, baby. I once knew this girl. She was a beautiful girl, right? But my man, my best friend, he said, man, that girl ain't no good for you. She just trying to use you. And I told him, I said, Gio, you don't even know. If she used you the way she used me, you would understand. 1, 2, 3, 4. Trying to tell me how all you want to do is use me. Nah, nah, but my answer to all that use me stuff. Now nah. I said, now I'm gonna spread the news that if it fails, it's good getting you. You just keep on using me like you wanted to, until you use me up. Sit me right down and he talked to me. He told me I'm not let you just walk on me. And I'm sure he meant well, nah, nah. But when I talk, what's though? It's what I said to him, baby. I said, big brother, if you only knew you wished that you were in my shoes, you just keep on using me. Until you use me to you get me in the crowd of high-class people, and then she act a real rude to me. But nah, nah, baby, 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 when you love me, I can't get enough. Now, I said now I'm gonna spread the know that if it feels it's God getting yours, you just keep on using me, until you use me up. Until you use me up. Get me in a crowd of high-class people, and then she act real rude to me, a real rude to me. But nah, nah, baby, 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 when you're loving me, I can't get enough. I said now I'm gonna spread the news that if it feels it's God getting your oats, you just keep on using me. Until you use me a heart.
Use me, baby.
She pick me macaroni, yeah. All she do is argue, fuss, and fight.
Argue, fuss, and fight.
She don't like being lonely, yeah. All she wanna do is come and stay tonight, yeah.
All stay the night.
She got them selfish ways, and
got a lot of crazy fantasies, yeah. But I wouldn't treat a dog, baby, the way you treated me, yeah.
I need a little misery, 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 baby. Misery, 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 baby. Misery, 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 baby. Misery, misery. I'm playing a little guitar.
Tell us or anything, tell your audience out there.
Keep it heavy, baby.
Absolutely. Absolutely.